It's about 25 crore to 50 million kids study in rural government schools. The statistics show that almost 80% of grade 5 kids are unable to read simple English text. And so it leaps forward through multiple rapid prototyping and multiple iterations. We have designed a solution whereby English can be learned through any regional language through a person who is not expected to speak English.
All these problems we talk about, environment and civic issues, the core problem is behavioral. We all know what has to be done, but none of us do what has to be done. We developed a process which can be replicated, which can be scaled, and using this process, one can attempt to solve these problems.
We went into the communities, spent a lot of time understanding what their needs are. At the rural areas and the tribal areas, we need to be able to provide primary care, we need to be able to provide preventive care, we need to be able to mobilize and motivate infrastructure development, and that is how we came up with a community health facilitator training program.
The biggest challenge is for rural populations, their exposure to good quality care. We create the platforms which enable them to connect with a city-based doctor and obtain medical consultations.
The media is the lens through which we see the world. How much do we not understand about the world and the way that it really is when we don't allow people to tell their own stories? So we would train people from the community as community producers. The idea of a community video unit was like it was a hyper-local news business for that area, but focused on social issues.
70% of the population of India is rural. Now, only 20% of the doctors, qualified doctors, actually stay in the rural areas. We have doctors on one end, we have the patients on another end. Just connect them with the help of video audio conferencing, let them talk to each other. Let us give them some diagnostics with the help of which the doctor can actually make a decision about the health status of the patient.
Founder of Ashoka says, nothing is more powerful than a unique idea in the hands of an exceptional entrepreneur. That's exactly what Ashoka does. We look for social entrepreneurs, people with unique ideas, approaches to a social problem. We search them, select them, and support them for the first 3 years financially. And they become a part of Ashoka. Ashoka has close to 3,000 Ashoka fellows across the globe, over 380 in this region in India. Ashoka fellows think systems. They identify deep-rooted causes where systemic changes need to be instituted. They come with unique solutions which not only hit the surface, but deeply rooted causes of those surface. We identify technology as a cross-cutting theme. And we assume that there will be a few social entrepreneurs, few Ashoka fellows who will need technology as an intervention to redefine their scale and impact.
Worldwide, we have been working with Ashoka for the past few years. Now in India, they are also looking for somebody to mentor the Ashoka fellows in terms of how to use technology to scale. We picked up those areas which is platform-based. So it could be used for education, it could be used for healthcare, it could be used for media. And then we picked up those lightweight technologies which could be used by the social entrepreneurs to scale.
So the journey with Ashoka has been very rewarding because they come with a breadth of experience in the area of large-scale social changes. How can social entrepreneurs be supported? And Oracle as an organization has always been looking out for these unique models of social change. We also got into an in-depth dialogue with these special fellows and helped them to understand and make their own social model more robust. So we had guided consultancy advice to them.
Ashoka is a network of social entrepreneurs. They give us an opportunity to have a forum where we can multiply our social impact. Ashoka was looking for advisors who can help social entrepreneurs who do not have a experience in scaling up businesses. And for us, it was an opportunity to create impact and create the multiplier effect we look for in our daily lives.
So about 25 crore to 50 million kids study in rural government schools. The statistics show that almost 80% of grade 5 kids are unable to read simple English text. Professional education in our country is accessible only in English, which means that is 250 million kids who access education will be severely limited in accessing professional education.
मेरा नाम ज्योति है मैं सातवीं कक्षा में पढ़ती हूँ मुझे खेलना अच्छा लगता है पढ़ाई करना अच्छा लगता है लिखने को भी अच्छा लगता है और मुझे स्कूल में जाने को भी अच्छा लगता है और क्लास में भी
So Leap Forward is a registered not-for-profit organization dedicated to the cause of solving the English learning challenge amongst the regional language background students. And so at Leap Forward, through multiple rapid prototyping and multiple iterations, we have designed a solution whereby English can be learned through any regional language through a person who is not expected to speak English.
आता सतीश आवश्यक माझ्या कुटुंबामध्ये 5 मेंबर्स आहेत 2 मुले 1 मुलगी आणि मिस्टर ते एक माझ्यासाठी मोठं आव्हान होतं म्हणजे जेव्हा मी इंग्लिश क्लास चालू केला तेव्हा वाडीत आणि आमच्या इथं पण लोक तसे बोलत होते की तुझं कमी शिक्षण आणि तुला इंग्लिश क्लास कसा येणार तेव्हा मला थोडंसं वाईट वाटलं कारण का कमी शिक्षण असल्यामुळे इंग्लिश शिकणं कठीण असतं आणि मग नंतर जेव्हा लीप फॉरवर्डचे माध्यमातून आम्हाला ट्रेनिंग दिलं गेलं ती एक आनंदाची गोष्ट माझ्यासाठी की मला इंग्लिश कमी येत होतं आणि मला इच्छा होती की इंग्लिश शिकायची तरी इंग्लिशच्या लीप फॉरवर्डच्या माध्यमातून मला ते शिकायला मिळालं आणि आता कुठेही इंग्लिशचा बोर्ड वाच लागलेला असेल तर मी पहिले तो बोर्ड वाचते इंग्लिश आली फॉरवर्डच्या माध्यमातून मला ते शिकायला मिळालं आणि मला खूप आनंद वाटतो त्याचा
The establishment, the validation of the innovations took a lot of effort. But now that once it's ready, we are actually trying to distribute it in a very FMCG-like model. So we're saying there have to be feet on street who will call on the 5 possible education consumption touch points. So like government schools, private schools, education focused not for profit organization, creating a battery of self-employed teacher entrepreneurs, and finally a mobile learning app for parents and volunteers. Then in Pune, every single consumption touch point has to be reached to share our solution. This field people invite people who have done their BA, DED without a job, call them for an exposure meeting, share what it means to be a teacher entrepreneur and how they can contribute to the illiteracy levels of the village, yet while earning money. Over the next 3 years, we have set ourselves a target to reach out to 2 lakh kids. Focused on a maximum of 6 districts in the state of Maharashtra.
हमें सुबह क्लास में स्वाक्षरी सिखाते हैं कैसे ए का आवाज ए होता है और आई का आवाज ई होता है और ई का आवाज ए होता है अब मैं कहीं भी जाती हूँ तब मुझे लिखा समझ में आता है कैसे लिखो समझ में आता है
एक असेल तर टूल आणि अनेक असेल तर टूल्स
Very early in my life as an Ashoka fellow, there was one thing that I learned from the Ashoka intervention is that The idea is primary, the business model is secondary. So it's important to make Leap Forward sustainable, important to scale it up, but the fact is that this idea works and this idea has to be shared with the world for the world to copy. I believe that this shift in mindset is Ashoka's contribution to my life.
Praneel came with this interesting challenge of how do you mainstream teaching English so that it's most accessible and it impacts wider livelihoods in the end. Now, what we saw as a gap there was the absence of a detailed drill down technology strategy which would equip Praneel to take it to the next level.
Rural areas and the tribal areas, we need to be able to provide primary care, we need to be able to provide preventive care, we need to be able to mobilize and motivate infrastructure development, and that is how we came up with the Community Health Facilitator Training Program. The flagship program, of course, is the Community Health Facilitator Training Program, where we educate these women, which is four-pronged. One is doing preventive health education, learning how to do the surveys in the villages, and identifying the health needs of the community so that they can develop projects that will health needs of the community.
My name is Kusum Devi. We have been doing training in the field. We give health information. Or whatever we have training, we go to the village and tell the women and women.
ये तो आपका रूरल फैन है ना, और यहाँ पे भी नहीं बना, यहाँ दो लाइन इंटरलाइन लगाकर बाद में लाइट भी आएगा, और ये सोखता दो बनाने से अच्छा लगेगा।
ट्रेनिंग में हमें हर स्वास्थ्य के बारे में जानकारियाँ दी गई थी, फर्स्ट स्टेज के बारे में भी बताया गया था, स्ट्रेचर कैसे बनाए जाते हैं, तिकोनी पट्टी कैसे बनाई जाती है।
There are three things that we have, three or four things in first aid that we repeatedly see happening. One is scorpion bites, second one is poisoning, third one is fractures, and the fourth one is burns, where community health facilitators have gone and used their first aid skills in saving lives and limbs and rushing them to giving the first aid and rushing them into the hospital.
So pehle hi hum kyon na iska first aid ka ilaaj aise laga dein aur lagane ke baad mein jaldi se hum doctor ke paas leke jaye.
As part of the training, the community health facilitator does a survey in the first month itself of about 30 families in her village to understand what the health needs assessment, health needs of that community is, to build soap pits, kitchen gardens, menstrual hygiene. These are some of the things that they have to do.
My name is Kiran Dubey and I have come from Healing Foundation to CHF training. In this village, I have a meeting for a week. और मैं उसमें आके लोगों को बताती हूँ, लड़कियों को बताती हूँ, उनके पैड के विषय में बताती हूँ, फिर से औरतों को जल के विषय में बताती हूँ, भोजन के विषय में बताती हूँ, पोषण आहार के विषय में बताती हूँ। ये लोग ये नहीं जानते थे कि पानी भी दूषित हो गया है मेरा, तो फिर मैं लोगों को बताया कि मेरे पानी दूषित हो गया है, आजकल आप लोग पानी छान करके पिए, पानी उबाल करके पिए, और ना हो तो बाजार से भी पानी मिलता है, फिल्टर्ड पानी उससे मंगा करके पिए।
मेरा नाम मंजू सिंह है, हीलिंग फील्ड्स की सदस्य हूँ, CHF की ट्रेनिंग ली हूँ एक साल के, उसके बाद आप लोगों के बीच मैं ये पैड का सेशन लेने आई हूँ।
The other important aspect is menstrual hygiene. We teach the adolescent girls and young women the importance of maintaining menstrual hygiene, and also we offer sanitary napkins at an affordable rate within the village so that these girls can go to the community health facilitators and buy the sanitary napkins. And the difference here is just not the usage, but also how do you dispose that sanitary napkin. What Ashoka has done is it has helped Healing Fields leapfrog the due diligence. So they bring in a lot of partnerships where we got pro bono consulting from A.T. Kearney, and also helped us recognize what are the changes that we need to bring in and helped us draw the roadmap.
Mukti had a great setup, but she was struggling to take the scale beyond, let's say, 2,000 villages. So what we did together with Mukti was we conceptualized how we can use simple apps. We helped decide how the app should work, how the user interfaces should work, so that it's very easy for these people at the grassroots level to execute.
Today, we have reached about 2,800 to 3,000 community health facilitators, and we are hoping to reach at least about 10,000, if not 20,000 by 2020.
College got over, like most people, I thought I'll sit for placements, but something told me not to opt for that. So along with two friends, started collecting garbage from about 100-150 households for about 9 months. While doing this, I realized a lot of things. First, I realized that all these problems we talk about, environment and civic issues, the core problem is behavioral. We all know what has to be done, but none of us do what has to be done. We have worked with about 100 to 200 schools, both private and government. One of the schools is Deccan International School in Bangalore. First, it took us about 1 to 2 years to, you know, kind of set systems in place with the students there. We started addressing water because water was an important issue to be solved there according to the school and the school management. I think we have saved in the last 2 to 3 years about 100,000 liters of water. So the first thing we made the students do was we provided them a water audit. The school was using water at some centers, the consumption was very high. So the first place was hand wash area. We kind of asked the students to measure. So we took a beaker, they switched on the tap for 10 seconds how much of water was coming, they gauged that.
Okay, so you can see that over here the flow is slowed down.
The students actually put this intervention inside the tap, and then we realized that the same beaker, which was full, you know, when we had no intervention inside the tap, almost was full for like 1/4 or like half. So the rest 3/4 or the half of the beaker was still free. So now imagine when you're washing the hands day in and day out in schools, how you can save a lot of water there. The Sri Kumaran Children's Home. This was a school which gave us the first opportunity of working with the students. We have been in the school for 4 years.
I'm Mrs. Deepa Sridhar, the principal of Sri Kumaran Children's Home CBSE, which is in Bangalore. We've been associated with Reap Benefit for the last 4 to 5 years. We very closely work with Kuldeep and Gautam as a team. These children have been working with environment and sustainability issues and probably expanding their horizons, which is beyond academics.
This is a power meter. This is the main tool or the instrument.
One of the first few things we did in this school, energy audit. So the first thing what we did was we reduced the brightness contrast. So we have a power meter. For the first time, the students actually understand how much of energy the computer is consuming. And once they understand, they work on the brightness contrast. And I think each computer saves about 1 unit per month. So imagine if there are 50 computers, 60 computers, they can do that. Simple intervention can be done by the students.
Now let's make it to zero. Yeah, I'll just show you the difference. Yeah. At zero, it has reduced.
We have seen now students coming up with a lot of solution when it comes to technology. And these students are taking technology to solve these problems. In this school, what we tried this year was the seniors went to the juniors and did the same activity what we did for them. Please come explain this thing, and we'll have Gautam explaining the technology part of it.
So basically, this dustbin has been divided into two parts.
My name is Namya Sinha. I'm from Sri Kumaran Children's Home and I study in the 11th standard now. I started working with Reap Benefit last year. Then I got to learn a lot. I may have a lot of ideas, but I don't have a platform to express it. So I think Reap Benefit gave me a platform like that.
So we have, as you can see, there are two sections here. One is
dustbins. That is one such intervention. which we have designed, the human-centered dustbins which enhance segregation. Now here we'll be putting sensors so that, you know, the support staff can take a more informed decision where waste is being put and how, what are the waste disposal patterns, and that will give them more knowledge on where the dustbin should be put and how the dustbin should be put, and the data will be communicated to the larger school. So these are some of the top things we have done, and now students have come up with their newer ideas. Now technology has come, and from these students we realized that we have to build an app wherein we can integrate everything together. So in more ways than one, we are understanding what the young people have to say and how we can go about building it. I've been an Ashoka Fellow since I think 2013, so it's been about 3 years now. The process of Ashoka kind of tried to make sure that Reap Benefit as an organization and me as an individual have that conviction. Also, I got access to a lot of interesting people. I got to speak to a lot of people I have admired. So these kind of things Ashoka kind of exposed me to. They were looking for ideas, I would like to believe, which can go global. And so when we met these people, we directly spoke about our work. They already had some background about our work. They had more meaningful insights to give. So from that, for us, that was very good because we got to meet more like-minded people who can help us accelerate our mission. So that was a very good process what Ashoka did.
Partners is mandated to deliver basic health care to rural communities. We are more influenced by the urgency of the need and communities which need the services today. The biggest challenges for rural populations, their exposure to good quality care, their benchmark is very, very different. For certain services which are currently available, if you try to make the same services available from a doctor based in the city, which will cost a little more, the rural communities are not very willing to absorb that cost. The fundamental approach is very, very simple. The traditional approach has been to try to induce these doctors to go in villages. That hasn't happened, that hasn't succeeded. What we do is to first train those providers who are available in rural areas to do certain things, which they can do on their own, such as, say, diarrhea management. What is needed is administration of rehydration solution. So anything beyond that, we create the platforms which enable them to connect with a city-based doctor and obtain medical consultations.
I'm Dr. Naren Mohan. I'm a संस्थान प्रभारी हूँ. तकरीबन 3 साल से ये स्काई हेल्थ सेंटर यहाँ पे संचालित हो रहा है. जब से ये स्काई हेल्थ सेंटर हम लोग चला रहे हैं, तब से काफी पेशेंट्स हमारे पास आ रहे हैं.
घबराओ नहीं, ठीक है ना, एक सुई लगाएंगे, रोना मत, ठीक है, बस हो गया.
शुरू में लोगों को ऐसा लगा कि जैसे जो हमारी प्रचार की गाड़ी आती थी या जो एडवर्टाइज होता था, उससे शुरू में लोगों को समझने में थोड़ा सा दिक्कत हुई कि ये क्या चीज़ है, कुछ नई है क्या है. लेकिन धीरे धीरे जैसे जैसे लोगों ने गांव-गांव में जाके प्रचार हुआ इसका, लोगों को बताया गया कि नहीं, इसमें आप दिल्ली के डॉक्टर से जो हाईली एजुकेटेड हैं उनसे आपका ट्रीटमेंट कराया जाएगा. देखिए, जो स्काई हेल्थ सेंटर ने जो ये नई टेली मेडिसिन जो टेक्नोलॉजी का इस्तेमाल किया है, उसमें अभी तक क्या था कि हम डॉक्टर के पास जाते थे, उसमें किराया भी ज़्यादा लगता था, पैसे ज़्यादा खर्च होते थे.
नमस्ते. हाँ मैम, ये पुराने पेशेंट हैं, ब्रजेश कुमार जी.
जी सही तो है.
इसमें अभी क्या है कि हम यहाँ से बैठ के ऑनलाइन डॉक्टर को अपनी परेशानी बताते हैं, और फिर उसके बाद वो डॉक्टर अपनी योग्यता के अनुसार अच्छी से अच्छी दवाइयाँ या जो हमको नीड है वो वहीं जाके पूरी होती थी, वो यहाँ पूरी हो जा रही है.
तबियत के लिए आपको सबसे पहले अपना खान पान, जैसे हरी सब्जियाँ खाएं, सलाद खाएं. जो आप बता रही हैं कि आपको गैस बनती है, गैस के लिए आपको क्या करना है, बिल्कुल भी मिर्च मसाले वाली चीज़ें. आई एम डॉक्टर विनीता शास्त्री, वर्किंग एज मेडिकल कंसल्टेंट इन CMI, द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ पार्टनर. दिस इज अ सेंट्रल मेडिकल फैसिलिटी. व्हेन वी आर ट्रीटिंग पेशेंट्स, दीज पेशेंट्स आर फ्रॉम रूरल पॉपुलेशन. तो व्हाट WHP इज डूइंग इज, WHP हैज क्रिएटेड लाइक दिस टेलीमेडिसिन सेंटर. वी सी पेशेंट थ्रू telemedicine. That is a technology which is like we are networking with the informal providers in the rural areas.
मेरा नाम ब्रजेश कुमार है. मैं ग्राम दुल्लापुर मलहमपुरवा का रहने वाला हूँ. मैं प्रेजेंट टाइम पढ़ाई भी कर रहा हूँ और जॉब भी कर रहा था. उस बीच में कांट मुझको सुबह शाम डेली अप डाउन करना रहता था जॉब के लिए. तो उसके बाद में अचानक मेरे सिर में और पेट में बहुत ज़्यादा पेन होने लगा. तो उस बीच में ना पढ़ाई पीछे अटेंड कर ज्वाइन कर पाया ना मतलब वर्क के लिए. तो इस बीच स्काई हेल्थ सेंटर की गाड़ी प्रचार के लिए गई थी. तो मैं स्काई हेल्थ सेंटर में आया तो यहाँ के जो डॉक्टर साहब हैं डॉक्टर नरेंद्र मोहन जी हैं तो उसने अपना भी दबा दिया. तो उससे मतलब थोड़ा रिलीफ नहीं मिला. तो सर बोले कि हम दिल्ली के डॉक्टर हैं उनसे बात कराएंगे आप बात कर लीजिए. मैंने प्रॉब्लम बताया अपने सारे वो मेडिसिन वहाँ से दिए जो उससे मुझको बहुत फ़ायदा हुआ. यहाँ पे जैसे बुखार जैसे हुआ तो यहाँ पे सर टेम्परेचर लगाते थे वहाँ के दिल्ली के डॉक्टर बैठ के वहाँ से सारे रिपोर्ट देख देते थे. वहाँ से सारी मेडिसिन वगैरह बता देते थे कैसे कैसे क्या देना है. गांव में शहरी इलाज आ जाने से गांव में बहुत ही लाभ हुआ है. सारी दवाइयाँ सारी सब कुछ फैसिलिटी सारे उपलब्ध हैं इसीलिए गाँव के लिए बहुत ही लाभदायक चीज़ है.
Very good opportunity, especially for networking, to meet people who are like-minded, who have similar interests, and who provide excellent, you know, opportunities or a platform for collaboration, partnerships. After our association began with the Ashoka Foundation, we have opportunities for interactions with a number of national and international organizations, and there are common avenues of interest, and that is wonderful for establishing partnerships.
Gopi is trying to create an enabler using technology which can make diverse people in primary healthcare connect with each other and scale the access to primary healthcare to the rural communities. A solution like Gopi's solution could be a trick that would impact the country as a whole.
With this film crew, the NGO that I was working with were there, and they were trying to interview a woman, and this outside filmmaker could not get this woman to open up. And then the community filmmaker, she sat down in the chair, she started talking to the woman, and it made me realize, the question I started asking myself was like, how much do we miss out? How much do we not understand about the world and the way that it really is when we don't allow people to tell their own stories? The media is the lens through which we see the world, and I think it's been deeply, deeply distorted for the last 50 years, if not longer. You know, over the last 10 years that Video Volunteers has been going, there are some positive things happening, which is, of course, the rise of digital media and the rise of cameras in everybody's pocket. But these changes are happening way too slowly. You know, we talk about how this digital revolution has happened. Well, it's only happened for some people. There's still 60% of the Indian population that doesn't have internet, and so effectively is excluded from this whole kind of YouTube revolution. You know, we have to accelerate the pace at which marginalized communities are connected. When we start any of our projects in Video Volunteers, we do a lot of surveying in the communities to understand what they feel about the mainstream media. They need to know, what can we do about it? What compensation do I get? What rights do I have around this? And how are we going to stop this as a community? This is the kind of information that people want, and this is what Video Volunteers is providing.
It's also equally important that the creativity approach that we talk about, we thought that all of that comes
And the idea of a community video unit was like it was a hyper-local news business for that area, but focused on social issues. So we would train people from the community as community producers, and we would place a trainer with them for 12 months, a professional filmmaker or a young recent film school graduate. And these correspondents would produce a monthly video news magazine of around 30 minutes on a different social issue.
My name is Suloshna Pednekar and I have done my post-graduation. Right now I'm enrolled for my PhD in women's studies. After that, I used to work with an NGO, during which time I used to go for field work to conduct surveys with people. So during that time, I realized that a lot of issues are not being tackled with the government. I joined Video Volunteers in March 2011. So it was actually a major change in my career path. Then I happened to know about Video Volunteers is looking for a community correspondent in North Goa. So I wrote to them and I told them like I'm interested in doing something. So then they looked at my profile and they said like, okay, what are you doing? What is your network with the community? And accordingly then they have taken me for the training. And after the training, then I was like whether I'll be able to do my shooting. There was major part where like we have to tell the story by facing the camera. It was not that only we have to shoot, but it was like we also have to tell, give the piece to camera. So that was major, like how I'm going to do it, whether I'll be able to. So I used to not like that part initially, but now I know that that is the major part which communicates to the greater audience to get the attention to those issues. This is Suloshna Pendekar reporting from Mapsa Goa for India Unheard.
I love Suloshna. I think she exemplifies so much of what makes for a great community correspondent. She's highlighting the problem, she's also explaining what the solution is, and then she's working for that solution.
Like any story has, means any issue is happening in the village or a community, people want that issue to be covered, so they have been asking mainstream media to come and cover that issue. When we explain to them that this is the community media, this is where you have to tell your story on your camera, so they come up with a story, what is the problem in their community, then we take that footage and then we arrange it like interview, B-rolls, and then we submit it in the Video Volunteers office.
When I was 25 years old, the program that I was with, the American India Foundation, was associated with Ashoka. It was in fact Ashoka that turned me on to the whole idea of becoming a change maker myself, in large part.
Jessica's problem was that she was looking at an interesting area where you had to create content from people who are not heard. You have many of these video volunteers in the field. Now, how do you connect them to the central repository? What we did in Video Volunteers is that we devised a mechanism where even videos which could not be streamed online could be done offline. So we basically looked at that entire workflow and then started giving her suggestions on areas where she could use technology.
Very peculiar situation where 70% of the population of India is rural. They live in 648,000 villages. Now only 20% of the doctors, qualified doctors, actually stay in the rural areas. So let's say there are doctors in the urban areas and there are these patients in the rural areas. The first thought that came to our mind is, can we connect? What we have is a range of traditional healers, a range of non-qualified people who have been doing this since generations. There are compounders of doctors who have returned back to the village and are practicing. So Neurosynaptic works very closely with the implementation partner for the ground rollout operations. One of the primary things there is training. How do you train the ground level nurse or the operator to be able to operate the technology?
I am going to explain about the telemedicine. What is telemedicine? Telemedicine means, tele means at a distance. Medicine means giving treatment to the patients.
Try to call all the operators at the same place and carry out a session on usage of technology and the ground level operations as well as the medical practices together with our implementation partner.
I am Rosemary, working in Meenakshi Mission Hospital as an assistant nursing superintendent. Now I am training the telemedicine nurses. We will take the nurses from the rural areas. We will give the training for 3 to 4 months. Then we'll post them there.
Second thing, village people are living daily, day-to-day activities. They will go for the work only.
We teach them how to deal with the patients. When the patient comes, give the respect, eye contact, with smiling approach. The basic things we'll teach them. And we'll put them in the wards, how to do the dressings, how to do the blood sugar, and how to check the HP. All the training we will give. And especially computer. See, we are working with the net-based work now, so we'll teach them how to handle the computer. That training also will be given part of that.
So I'm Samir. I represent Neurosynaptic Communications. What I have brought to show you is the new technology. We at Neurosynaptic developed a remedy for addressing the healthcare needs of the rural population. Remedy stands for Remote Medical Diagnostics. It's a comprehensive platform which comprises of three primary components. One, which is a front-end diagnostics at the village. Second, which is a audio and video conferencing. And third, which is the patient medical records. One is a glucometer and a cholesterol meter. So with this, you can take glucose and cholesterol readings. There is also a hemoglobin meter, which basically takes... Remedy Nova is the latest technology that we have developed. It comprises of three things. One is the wide range of diagnostics that we have come up with. The second part of it is completely cloud enabled, which means I can access this from anywhere. And the third part of it, which is basically mobility. And this mobility comes through the usage of mobile phones.
நான் என் பேர் விஜய். நான் இந்த தோணுகால் ஊரை சேர்ந்தவன். நான் இங்கேயே பிறந்து படித்து இந்த ஊர்லேயே கல்யாணம் முடித்தவன். இந்த ஊர்லேயே கல்யாணம் முடித்ததுனால இங்கே எனக்கு மீனாட்சி மிஷன் ஹாஸ்பிட்டலேருந்து டெலிகேர் சென்டரில் எனக்கு நர்ஸு வேலை கிடச்சிருக்கு. இந்த டெலிகேர் சென்டரில் வர்ற பேஷண்ட்டுகளை பெரும்பாலும் எங்கள் உள்ளூர்காரங்க, பக்கத்தில் இருக்கிறவங்க எல்லோரும் தெரிஞ்சவங்கனால, தெரிஞ்ச பொண்ணு இருக்கிற அவங்ககிட்ட போய் பார்ப்போம் அப்படின்றதுனால வர்றதுனால அவங்ககிட்ட பேசுகிறது பழகிறது எல்லாமே எனக்கு ரொம்ப ஈஸியாக இருக்குது. அவங்கக்கிட்ட நார்மலாக பேசி அவங்களோட வியாதி என்ன, அவங்களுக்கு என்ன தொந்தரவு இருக்குது என்னன்னு கேட்டுக்கிட்டு அதன் பின்னாடி அவங்களுக்கு வைட்டல்ஸ், ஹைட்டு, வெயிட்டு, பிபி, தேவைப்பட்டால் சுகர், ஸ்டெத்து இதெல்லாம் பார்த்துக்கிட்டு தேவைப்பட்டால் டாக்டர்கிட்ட கனெக்ட் பண்ணுவோம்.
என் பேர் சாவித்திரி. தோணாலு கிராமத்தில் பிறந்தவங்க. எனக்கு கொஞ்ச நாளைக்கு முன்னாடி தொண்டை வீக்கமாக இருந்துச்சு, ரொம்ப வலியாக இருந்துச்சு. முதல்ல கண்டுக்கிறாம விட்டுட்டோம். வேதனை அதிகமானதுனால திருப்பி கவர்மெண்ட்டுக்கு போயிருக்கோம். ஹாஸ்பிட்டலேருந்து 2.5 மாதம் பார்த்தோம், இன்னும் அது எதுவும் சரிபடலை.
சாவித்திரி, என்ன செய்யுது உங்களுக்கு?
எங்கள் ஊரில் மருத்துவமனை இருக்குன்னு கேள்விப்பட்டோம், அங்கே வந்து காமிச்சோம்.
தைராய்டு இருக்குன்னு எப்படி தெரியும்?
மருத்துவமனையில் டெலிமிஸ்டின்னு சொல்லி ஒன்று இருக்கிறதா கேள்விப்பட்டோம். கேள்விப்பட்டதுனால ஃபோன் போட்டு மூலயமா மருதில் இருக்கிற டாக்டரோட பேச வச்சாங்க. கையால் அசதி, மாதத்துக்கு 2 தடவை விளையாளானேன். அந்த மையத்திலே அந்த டாக்டருங்களை பார்த்து என்னோடய உடம்புல இருக்க பிரச்சனைலாம் சொல்ல முடிஞ்சு. அங்கே இருக்க நர்ஸு ஒரு சீட்டை கொடுத்து மருதில் இருக்க மீனாட்சி மிஷனுக்கு போச்சுனாங்க.
அப்படி பார்க்க வேண்டிய பேஷண்ட்டுகளை இங்கே டாக்டரோட பரிந்துரையின் பேரில் நாங்கள் இங்கேருந்து மீனாட்சி மிஷன் அனுப்புகிறோம்.
அவர் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல், ஈவன் தோ வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் மோர் பேஷண்ட்ஸ் இன் அவர் ஹாஸ்பிட்டல், அவர் மோட்டோ இஸ் நோ மேன் இஸ் டூ புவர் டு அஃபோர்ட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கிரேட் மெடிக்கல் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட். இன் தட் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் வி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு டூ அவர் ஹெல்ப் இன் த ரூரல் ஏரியாஸ். வென் த பேஷண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் கம்மிங் ஃப்ரம் த சென்டர், வி ஆர் கிவிங் 50% கன்செஷன்.
என்னன்னா?
இந்த சீட்டை ஹாஸ்பிட்டலில் காமிக்கும்போது டாக்டர் மூலமா அப்பாயின்மெண்ட் போட்டு கொடுத்துருக்கேன். ஆஸ்பத்திரிக்கு போனோம், டாக்டர் எங்களை பார்த்தாரு, டயர்டாக இருக்குன்னு சொன்னாங்க, ஆப்ரேஷன் பண்ணால் சரியாக போகும்னு சொன்னாங்க. இந்த மாதிரியான மருத்துவ வசதி இந்த கிராமத்தில் இருக்கிறதுனால எங்களுக்கு ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமாக இருக்குது.
I became an Ashoka Fellow in 2013. As a part of the Globalizer program, we rethought our strategies towards cloud. We strategized our diagnostics that we offer at the point of care, and we strategized our markets on how to approach them.
I remember that, you know, a couple of our senior colleagues from Oracle, they worked with Samir, one of the fellows which Oracle is supporting, to help him understand that what are the linkages which he needs to make and what are the things which he needs to build into his system of offering, so that it becomes an easy scalable model to replicate and reach out to a larger number of people who really need the help. And this was done over a period of 3 to 4 weeks of intense consultation and working together with the fellow.
So we are actually very thankful to Oracle for all the contributions that they have made into this solution for creating larger impact.
Ashoka would continue to find exceptional social entrepreneurs like Ashoka Fellows. We have the critical mass already in place of the social innovations which will bring much bigger, larger mass impact that India needs today. And Ashoka is committed to continue electing more Ashoka Fellows going forward, who would like to amplify and would join hands with Ashoka in this vision of everyone a change maker.